feel good.
No, nice to have your company. I tell you what, Bill, the game's stuffed. Nah, seriously.
Yes, I think so.
I can't. I'm watching last night. Oh, my God. What the hell is going on? Yep. What's happened to our great game?
Mm.
Anyway, we're going to get to that a bit later on. But I tell you what we've got today is Rawsa Sloan.
Well, yes,
speaking
please.
Of great, love him, of course. Clangers of the week, courtesy of our great friends at Amy, and then something to finish the show from you that hopefully is better than last night.
Actually, it was good last night.
No, it wasn't.
Good feedback.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ratsy laughed.
Are you fat?
G'day, Jimmy boy. Great to be in the studio to actually see you.
Have a look at you.
And you're looking fit. Fitness
well, been,
gym today.
I've been at the gym, yeah. Well,
Jim's been at the gym.
In my own garage.
Have you?
Yeah, that's basically where we can't leave your house. So I'm in the garage.
I must admit, I haven't been to a gym for a while.
You don't. It looks like you haven't.
And so does, just looking at him too, Rabsy. Wowee.
Mistake. Yeah, well done, Robert. Yeah, we dropped. Thank you, Robert. Righto. Shut up, Robbo.
Robbo's got something to say.
That's almost the best.
Shut up, Robbo.
Robbo.
Shut up.
Did he drop into the Sunday footage?
It's my body seat, and I got Robbo like a little muppet in the background.
Well, that's when Robbo came on to the Sunday footy show,
right.
Jim.
Yes.
But he was supposed to go, and, you know, Robbo likes
around.
To hang around.
Yes.
And then he came into the next segment, and the next segment, like, fair dinkum, Robbo. I know you're a good-looking man who's about 60.
No, in his early 80s.
80s, and very nicely toasted.
Well, toasted. He latched onto the cream early, didn't
yeah, he?
Did. Rubber,
yeah,
the moisturising cream,
yeah,
and stayed with it for a good 50 years.
Oh, he does look
and
good.
He's like Benjamin Button.
He is. And a good fella. G'day to Rubber.
Great fella.
I tell you what, Melbourne, Jim, last night, feeding him. At half time, they kicked 1-3. I know it was slippery and wet.
Nah,
at three quarter time, 2-4. Someone said this morning that the Melbourne Football Club, you know what they are? They're empty. Not a bad. I thought that's all right.
Well, since they played in that prelim in Perth, we saw the numbers last night. They've won 12 and lost 25 games
12?
Since that day.
Wow, there
so,
you
Bill,
go.
That is not even close to good enough.
And no connection between still the midfield and the forwards.
No.
And the mids are getting plenty of it. Last night, Oliver, 25.
Yeah,
Petrarca,
it.
25. Viney, 27.
That's it.
Gawn was very, very good. So they're all getting the ball. What's happening?
But Fat, for me, the classic example of what you're just talking about there was playing for the other team, and that is David Mundy. He's one of my favourite players
spot-y-o.
Ever. It doesn't matter how many times he gets it. It's what he then does with
that's
it.
That's spot on.
And he never wastes the footy, and he always puts it into the most dangerous position. So Clayton Oliver, who I like, by the way.
Yeah.
But I tell you, if I'm goody, I'm handing him game tape of David Mundy going, mate, that's how a midfielder optimises getting the ball. So watch what
point.
He does.
And that's the problem. Yeah, right. You're spot on. But they're good players are playing well, Jim. You know, you say, someone's Geelong are going well. It's because of the good players are playing well. Well, Melbourne's good players are playing well. And guess what?
Geelong's good players use the ball well, Bill. That's the
they're
thing.
A better team. Geelong.
There's no point getting it 30 times if you cough it up.
Well, they're frustrating, aren't they?
No, they are. So really they've got big issues, no doubt about it.
Two games tonight, Jim. Adelaide Crows. When are we going to talk to Rory? Because he's playing tonight.
We're going to latch onto him early.
All right, then. Yep. And the Giants. That's on at 5:40 Adelaide Oval.
Yes.
And then Carlton. This is a good game. Yeah. Interesting game. Carlton taking on Sydney at Metricon.
Yes.
Couple of outs for Carlton caught my attention.
Right.
Eddie Betts managed. What's happening with Eddie Betts?
Well, he's getting to the back end.
Right.
He's been an absolute
Does
champion.
He play
in the game.
Next year.
Don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Don't know.
Perhaps, not that I'll give a stuff, but what do you think?
Well, Daisy said last night in the footy coverage that he's good for the junior blokes there, and particularly the Indigenous ones. So if he doesn't play next year, he'll still have a role at the club.
Right. Daisy texted me. He didn't get on Crystal Chief yesterday.
No, he wasn't happy.
He sucked in. The other one is Paddy Dowell's been dropped again. They'd play him.
I reckon they need to.
Yeah.
They got a very, very highly rated kid taken high in the draft. I think taken three, was he, Paddy Dowell overall?
Three or four.
So, they've got to find a way to get him up and running.
Exactly. The US Open, Jim, and tennis. I tell you what, Alex Dimonor is a star.
Yes.
And this happened last night.
We're all watching ahead right here.
Game
and he gets it done. The 21-year-old headed to the quarterfinals here at the U.S. Open. Straight sets win.
Straight sets, Alex.
Well, so.
Yes. So the other semi-final, Tim.
Yes.
Is between Danny Medvedev.
Yes.
And Audrey Rublev.
Where are they from?
Well, they're from. Hey! Both from Russia, Jim.
That's it, Pat.
Both from Russia. Oh, how good is that? That song gets me up and going.
That's beautiful.
Oh, it's a great song. Got something else for you coming up too, a bit of audio.
Hello.
Soccer, Jim, this caught my eye.
Yes.
Premier League stars Mason Greenwood and Phil Foden.
Foden.
Yep. Well, it depends where you come from. Have been axed from the England squad for inviting two girls back to their hotel. They're playing a friendly over in Iceland, Jim.
Ooh. My man, the vest-wearing Gareth Southgate.
That's it. He's the manager.
Not happy.
No, he wasn't happy. He sent them home. Obviously, coronavirus guidelines there and things like that. Yes. But, Jim, would you rather be playing in a friendly for England or being invited or inviting back Miss Universe Iceland?
What
it's
the
so
hell is
strong.
That?
That's an Iceland song, Jim.
No. Come on.
Have a listen to it. It's like ding dong. Do you know anyone else famous from Iceland, Jim?
No.
Nothing.
Was she actually Miss Universe or was she their contestant?
She was a contestant.
Right.
What about this? You know what this is? You know what? It's a Viking clap.
Oh, is it? Right.
Yeah, that's what they started it in Iceland.
Right.
When back in the day when the Vikings used to have a good kill.
Right.
They'd all come marching back and do the Iceland clap.
Yes.
Viking clap.
And also, the Viking cap clap. But I think, Jim, I was trying to get to a very funny gag.
Yeah, let's go on then.
But I also think that a few of the Vikings got the clap.
Oh, no. Is that the funny one you were getting to? Yeah.
Would have been better. Probably, anyway, those boys have been sent home to England, so that's bad luck.
Mm.
But Miss Universe, she was.
I think the joke that Jill gave you to use was maybe Phil Foden now has the Viking clap.
Yeah. Oh, so you should have gone with that one.
Well, I didn't like the way Jill framed it. also, Jim, I tell you what, Damo gave us a bit of a tease or a hint yesterday, but there is trouble up in the hub.
No, I told you that.
He did tell us that.
I told you that in the rub on Saturday.
Yes, well.
And then backed over it yesterday. My mail out of that hub is electric.
Well.
They're grandparents. There are board members. There are all sorts of people hubbing, Bill, who have got no part to play in this season at all.
Well, on Footy Classified last night, Tony Chompers Jones.
Chompers.
He was a late in because poor old Hutchie was a late scratching Hutch.
He's got the issues. Croc Media.
Croc Media, there's a bit of something going around there. So, anyway, Hutchie out, Tony Jones in, and he said that it's out of control.
Mm.
As you said, Jim, there's grandparents, babysitters. No, the girlfriend of a reporter.
Oh, come on.
Someone from up there has got to take the girlfriend up there from Fox. There's even suggestions a swimming coach.
Bill.
A swimming coach has gone up for the kids, Jim.
I thought with this pandemic that we may have finally gotten rid of the thing that's been hanging around the AFL for as long as I can remember.
What's that?
The junket.
Jim,
I thought, Bill, with all the money going out of the game, we might have finally gotten rid of the liniment-sniffing junket that has been part of the AFL forever. Clearly not.
No.
Mate, Bill, 400 people, my understanding is at least 200 of them have got no reason to be there. No reason at all.
So it's 400 strong party of AFL officials, families and media members.
That's it.
So you're saying there should only be 200 there?
Well, Bill, people are turning up with wives, kids, grandparents,
swimming coaches.
You can't tell me they all need to be there.
Well, apparently there's two pools at the Mercura gym and they're both full. The bar's open from 5 to 8. You're only allowed 2 drinks at a time. And they're very, very busy at the bars because there's some thirsty people there, Jim.
Come on. Come on. Well, the Chompers is onto it.
He's onto it, old Chomp.
All right, thanks for joining us, Drew, and we'll see you on the Footy Show tonight.
Thanks, Chompity, Chomp, Chomp, Chomp.
Okay, thanks for that.
Thanks for that, yeah. So that's it. Nice wrap.
Oh, that's all?
Yeah, that's all.
All right. Well, not a bad one.
Not bad. I had a bit of everything.
Sort of too bad.
A bit of soccer, a bit of tennis, a bit of footy.